Hello, and welcome to this presentation of the STM32WB Extended Interrupts and Events Controller, or EXTI. The Extended Interrupt and Event Controller, or EXTI, provides 44 independent events, split into two categories, configurable events and direct events. Applications benefit through smarter use of low power modes, taking advantage of the STM32WB's capability to wake up each CPU independently via external communication or requests. The Extended Interrupt and Event Controller provides a single interrupt per configurable event to both CPUs. Individual CPU wakeups are provided to allow independent wakeup of both processors. The dual-core STM32WB microcontroller has independent event generation logic for each CPU. This is the block diagram of the Extended Interrupt and Event Controller. Configurable events are generated by peripherals without interrupt capability, but which are able to issue a pulse. The EXTI controller provides interrupt detection, masking, and software trigger. Direct events are generated by peripherals supporting interrupt requests. In this case, the EXTI controller is used to generate events to the CPU and to request system wakeups. The Extended Interrupt and Event Controller provides a single interrupt per configurable event to both CPUs. Individual CPU wakeups are provided to allow independent wakeup of both processors. The Extended Interrupt and Event Controller can generate interrupts and events, as well as wake up the processors from stop modes. Configurable events are linked with external interrupts from GPIOs, RTC, TAMP, PVD, PVM, comparators COMP, and CPU sent event. Direct events are linked with I2C, USARTs, LPUART, LPTIM, USB, IPCC, HSEM, Flash, LCD, and Debug. The Cortex M supports two ways to enter a low power state. 1. Executing the Wait for Event or WFE instruction. Or 2. Executing the Wait for Interrupt or WFI instruction. With WFE, the first instruction executed after a wake-up event is the next sequential one, INSTR N plus 1 in the sequence on the left. By implementing WFI, the processor jumps to the interrupt service routine when an enabled interrupt request is received. Note that an interrupt request is a WFE exit condition, but an event received on RxEV is not a WFI exit condition. For the STM32WB series, the event generation is only available from the listed peripherals. This figure aims to explain the various stages enabling the conversion of a configurable event active edge into an interrupt request. The first stage is the asynchronous edge detection circuit configured by two registers, EXTI RTSR1 and EXTI FTSR1. Any edge, possibly both, can be chosen. The software can emulate a configurable event by setting the corresponding bit in the EXTI SWIER register. The bit is auto-cleared by hardware. An AND gate is used to mask or enable the generation of the interrupt to the CPU NVIC. Finally, a flag is set in the EXTI PR1 register when the interrupt is generated to the CPU NVIC. This flag enables the software to determine the cause of the interrupt. This flag is expected to be cleared by the interrupt service routine. This figure aims to explain the various stages enabling the conversion of a configurable event active edge into a processor event. Both configurable and direct events can be configured to issue events to the CPU, steered to its RxEV input. Unlike interrupt requests, the CPU has a unique event input, so all event requests are OR'd together before entering the event pulse generator. The registers used to mask the generation of events are different from the ones used to mask the generation of interrupts. EXTI EMR instead of EXTI IMR. The dual-core STM32WB microcontroller has independent event generation logic for each CPU. The CPU's wake-up signals generated by the EXTI block are connected to the PWR block and are used to wake up the system and CPU subsystems bus clocks. Both configurable and direct events are able to request a wake-up. A wake-up occurs when an asynchronous edge detection circuit has detected an active edge. Consequently, software is expected to clear the flag in the EXTI PR1 register to disable the wake-up request when the source of the wake-up is a configurable event. For direct events, the flag is located in the peripheral unit. These flags enable the software to find the cause of the wake-up. The wake-up indication is asserted when either the wake-up or the event generation is enabled. See the OR gate combining EXTI IMR and EXTI EMR registers. All CPU wake-up signals are OR'd together and then OR'd with the event requests. SysWakeup is asynchronous and wakes up the clocks. Once HCLK is running, the synchronous C1 wake-up and or C2 wake-up is generated to wake up the respective CPU. A direct event is able through the EXTI controller to generate a CPU event and trigger a system wake-up. The active edge of direct events is the rising edge. Direct events do not rely on the EXTI controller to assert interrupt requests because they have their dedicated lines to the NVIC. Otherwise, the same circuit as the one described in the previous slides are implemented. Direct events can be independently masked for event generation and interrupt generation. The interrupt mask in the EXTI controller is only used as a wake-up mask. The extended interrupt and event controller is linked with the nested vector interrupt controller and the Cortex M4 CPU. Please refer to the related presentations. For detailed information, please refer to the programming manual for the STM32F3, F4, L4, and L4 Plus series, and the reference manual of the STM32WB series.